That was my same issue with Kaepernick. Granted, he decided to stand alone, but without unification.
He didn't decide to stand alone. He just stood alone.
He just stood alone. And then Eric Reed came and joined him. But the fact is that you decided to do something, but you got nobody to join you. Your movement didn't accomplish what you sought out to accomplish. Furthermore than that, the message and the reason why you were doing it is totally lost because of the method you chose. Now, since day one, I've always said the method he chose was stupid. I could have told him that I understand why, but the way you want to do it is going to get lost because of what people are going to take from what you're doing.
Here's my problem with that statement. This is not a new situation that black people have been fighting for basic civil rights for a long time. A long time.
I think we agree.
I would certainly hope so. But that's not hard to see. But just like he said, it's a Facebook post here. It's a retweet there. It's a, man, this is messed up. But
hey, hold on. It's a Facebook post while you're watching the football game.
Yeah, look, you know, it's a very small
thing. Or live from the stadium.
So you have all these different people trying to get their message across using a bunch of platforms, and obviously nothing is working. So now you take something that they've been fighting about for even on the decades and decades and decades they've been fighting for this same cause that we're dealing with today. As soon as he did that, the protesting by kneeling for the national anthem to protest police brutality and social injustice, it was, now we're talking about it for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 months, a year after. A conversation that couldn't even get started before is now not only started, but it's rolling, it's active, it's picked up steam, and it's got people like myself that initially was shocked in the beginning. I'm like, oh man, that is just, you know, because my dad, even though he came from Africa, he realized that he had a lot of opportunities over here, and he said, I love this country. This country's given us great opportunities, so we'll respect it. But now, so initially I'm like, oh man, this is bad. This is bad. But then the more you look at it and the more you listen to him, it's not, it's still his right. So now if you can take all this new data that we have gotten from all the discussions that have been spurned from that, because they're still going. We're still talking about the anthem protest today.
But hold on, we're not talking about
anything else from before.
Well, I agree, and I'm going to ask Robin to jump in on this. But has the message, is it so lost that we're not even making any progress because of the method he chose created a whole nother issue with people seeing what he did as disrespectful to the military? Even though that wasn't his intention, a lot of people took it that way.
I don't think the message was lost, as you had stated. I mean, it is being talked about, you know what I mean? It's definitely being talked about. But I do agree. I think there was probably better measures how it could have been handled. I don't know, a different way he could have done his protest, because now it is, the message wasn't lost, but it could have been a lot more clear, mm-hmm. You know? So, but I don't know what that would have looked like for him.
Yeah, I agree, and I've said that before, and I'll go to Sean. I'll go to Sean first. I've said that before. I agree with you. I know for a fact there is a better way. I have yet to figure out what that better way was, because in trying to solve a problem, you created another one. Right. It's like in trying to bring attention to an issue, you created division, and division is opposite of a solution, because you got a lot of people who would have been on your side had you done it differently, because the issue or how they view what
you've been doing it differently, Dollar.
But hold on. I'm not saying that they haven't, but
they've they've sat in roads, they've concreted themselves.
I'm not disagreeing that, but I'm not disagreeing that. I'm also going to say, it did work. We've gotten further. It made progress. The goal is always progress, Sean.
Nah, the kneeling was the right thing to do. And the reason why I say that is something is better than nothing.
I don't always agree with that.
Whether or not, this is the thing. So, I mean, you can go back to everything that started a movement and say there was 25 different ways you could have done it. Absolutely. But it sparked the place we are right now. Like he said, a year from now, the NFL made a whole nother rule because of what he, and the message isn't lost. The message was never lost. The thing is if I'm targeting you, if I'm coming at you about something that you know is wrong and you have no answer for, you gotta deflect to something else.
I agree, but isn't it the mark of a wise man to calculate that in your movement? I mean, it's chess, not checkers.
This is the thing. A movement isn't always about making a wise move. A movement is about doing something.
Hold on, now everything
what happens after me jump? If I jump in front of traffic to say that I want to save this child, I'm not thinking I could get hit. I'm making a move.
But we know the move.
And now what happens after I get hit is now you're gonna see a sign and you're gonna. Sometimes you have to sacrifice something.
But that don't mean that. But that don't mean that was the best way to go about it.
No, it wasn't.
Like, for example,
Rosa Parks could have shook her fist in the back of the bus all she wanted, and Selma never happens.
No.
It happened because she took a stand.
Hold on, no. That's not why it happened. Pause. Hold on. No. Don't get it twisted. That's not why it happened. Because a lot of people refused to get up before Rosa Parks did. But it's because strategically Rosa Parks was placed there.
She did not. And if you go back in history, she said, "I sat down." Why?
So is this conspiracy?
I was tired.
No.
Because I was tired. But hold on, she wasn't trying to make a movement.
Hold on.
I was tired.
Thank you. My point is, she knew what she was doing, but she also knew. Hold on. Yes, she did.
I'm gonna tell you how. I sat down because I was tired.
I know that's what her words was, but let's take 10 seconds. Who was Rosa Parks? She knew who she had in her back pocket. She knew who she worked for. She knew the power she had behind her. She knew she already worked for the NAACP. They already knew what she was going to do. That wasn't an accident that she decided.
The NAACP at that time.
It doesn't matter. But it doesn't. It meant enough to create what they did.
It was a target on your back.
Hey, look.
To say you're part of the NAACP.
Call it what you will. Call it what you will. It was a strategic. It wasn't accidental that the secretary of the president of the NAACP decided to not get up. That wasn't accidental. All I'm saying is that, yes, Colin has started a conversation, but I agree with her that there was probably a better way that had he reached out, maybe to Dr. Dyson, or maybe to your boy at Yale with the hair that was in the Matrix.
Had he done that? That people always reach out to when nothing has happened.
No. What I'm saying is, but I know. But
Jesse Jacks. Go. I mean, go down.
No. But
what has changed? By calling them and saying, "Look, hey, sir, you know, it's that like this."
No,
man,
no. What you do is
his
this.
NFL career, his livelihood.
His NFL career. Hold on. That's a whole other conversation.
He risked his livelihood.
All I'm saying
is, you don't think he thought about it? Was like, you know what? At this point, I'm at the end of my contract. I should just stand.
He wasn't at the end of his contract.
He
had 2 years left.
He had 2 years left.
But they were getting ready to whether decide.
They were getting ready to cut him because I think he saw that he was going
to
get cut.
And he chose to.
Because he wasn't that good of a player.
But at the same time, he's way better than half of the quarterbacks that are on somebody's.
Theoretically. All I'm saying is this. If the goal is to get.
If your system fits that skill set.
Hold on. If your goal is to get something done, you don't just do anything. You take a second and figure, especially not someone with the reach and the resources that he has. There's no, in my head, and this is what I tell him, frat brother and all, I appreciate what you tried to do. I know where your heart was at. But I'm disappointed that before you did something that drastic, you didn't take a second to ask somebody. A wise man learns from the mistakes of a fool. There's enough people. Hold on.
No, because you're stating
the
fallacy.
He asked him after the fact.
And he switched. When he sat for the anthem, that was the first time. He sat on his seat. He did not stand when everybody else stood.
Question.
Then he consulted somebody, and they said, if you want to make a stand, you take it.
Heavyweight, you're making my point. You're making my point. What I'm saying is.
What is your point?
My point. What I'm saying is before he decided to, I'm going to take a stand and protest. I'm going to sit in protest of XYZ. Before he did that. Had he consulted some people, he would have never done that. Do you at least understand what I'm saying?
I understand what you're saying. I just don't see the premise in that. Because do you think he just decided out of the blue?
Yeah.
And you know, I'm getting ready for a ball
this
game,
happened,
but maybe I'll just sit down.
This same thing
happened hasn't been
after
talking
Tim
to people.
Tebow did the exact same thing. I'm kneeling in protest because of abortion, because the United States, the exact same thing before him. So why should I have to consult somebody when I seen somebody do it before me?
I can answer that easily.
Please do.
Because you ain't got the skin Tebow do. You got to do.
He do.
Hold on,
he do.
No, you don't. No, he don't. No, you don't.
Technically, he do.
And then, hold on.
And I'm gonna leave it this because we gotta go to the next topic.
Of course, I'm gonna leave with it.
Of course, that's the benefit of being a host. I gotta say this. He further messed up his cause with the pig socks. You can't do that.
That I could say.
You can't do that.
I'm not saying he made some perfect moves.
You can't
I'm
do
just
that.
Saying. I think it's silly to think that.
So we're gonna agree that it was better than nothing.
No, it wasn't better.
I disagree, because I don't think it was better than
if you care about your cause enough, you will do what needs to be done, and what was being done was not effective. I'm sure he talked to a bunch of people, which is why
he came up with the idea. He didn't. He talked to them after
this
the fact.
Country does not reflect the ideals that I feel it should, so I'm not going to sit here and salute it like everything is okay, and that is his choice.
I get it.